Good afternoon, advisors, delegates, staff, and honored guests. Welcome to the closing ceremonies of Vancouver Motto United Nations 2021. VIMA this year was one unlike any other. We faced challenges that secretariats past never had to confront. Yet as we watched the intellectual banter and riveting speeches transpire in the committee room, we knew that our uphill battle had borne fruit. Each member of the secretariat team was also once a shy, or perhaps eager, delegate like those of you listening now, hoping that our voice will leave an impact. And it was our own memorable experiences at VIMON that drove us to take on the trial of organizing, planning, and facilitating a conference, even amidst a pandemic. At the end of the day, we are simply a group of high school students trying to create something bigger than ourselves. So we want to thank you today, delegates, for showing us your passion and dedication, for inspiring us confidence in the next generation of leaders, and for making all our hard work worthwhile. There is nothing more humbling than being able to see the groundwork we set blossom into something so much greater. However, for all the credit that the Secretariat has been given, VIMA would not have been possible this year without the assistance and diligence of those behind the scenes. First, thank you to Christina Su, our advisor and media team, whose artistic talents in conference photography and videography illuminated our conference. Thank you to Noah Cohen, whose videography made this speech possible. Thank you to this year's sponsor teachers and chaperones, each of whom had to keep track of various correspondences, extend their patience, and supported us along the way. And last, but certainly not least, thank you to Brenda Kelly, our chaperone who continued to believe in us and help fulfill our dream in spite of all the challenges. In many ways, they've just been as important as the secretariat, and we cannot express enough our appreciation for their efforts towards our conference. With all that said, I'd now like to hand it off to our Chief of Staff.
Good afternoon, delegates, staff, sponsors, and my fellow secretariat members. My name is Derek Wu, and for the past 8 months, it has been the honor of my high school years to serve as your Chief of Staff for VIMON 2021. The essence of what VIMON seeks to do is to build global citizens. No, it is not about the number of times you speak or the awards you win. Model United Nations seeks to expose you to the multitude of perspectives out there, connect you with talented and intelligent people, and teach you skills you will learn and use for a lifetime. Delegates, I sincerely hope that you have all seen what diplomacy and debate truly is about over these 3 days. While the Secretariat placed their heart and soul into shaping a substantive program for VIMON this year, ultimately, this conference would be nowhere near as successful or rewarding without each and every one of our 70 staff members. Staff, between the day you were first interviewed and hired to today, the final day of the conference, the skies outside have changed from warm sun to wintry snow. You've all come a long way these 8 months. You all embrace the challenge of an online conference without letting go of your commitment, hard work, and passion. Whether you spent sleepless nights researching the ethics of counterterror, or if you simply did your best to get to know your dais teams and rules of procedure, each of you have allowed your committees to shine brightly in their own unique way, with a warmth, enthusiasm, and professionalism that is truly remarkable. I will admit that along the way, you've made me want to tear my hair out on multiple occasions, but that's in the past. What matters now is what you have achieved. VIMON 2021 has been a success. So be relieved, be happy, be proud. I thank each and every one of you from the bottom of my heart. It puts a smile on my face to know that the world ahead is filled with so many bright minds ready to be the leaders who tackle the darkness, division, and discord that plague our society. On the day I first walked into VeeamON 2018, I was still sullen about my committee assignment of Dissect Mozambique. I could never have imagined I was just opening to chapter one of a three-year journey in Model United Nations. On the day I gave my director's speech to close off the Historical Crisis Committee at VeeamON 2020, I could never have imagined the rigors that I would soon go on to experience as a secretariat member. On the day I edited my first backgrounder as chief of staff, I could never have imagined that one day all 35 backgrounders would be far away in the rearview mirror and I would be here, giving my speech at the closing ceremonies of VeeamON 2021. And yet here we are, at that final chapter. The world of Model UN has become a second home to me, and that has only been possible because of our secretariat team. Thank you, William, Vivian Gu, Tyler, Vivian Liang, Jonah, Laura, Armand, and Mia. Thank you for being on this journey with me. But most of all, thank you, Joyce and Ethan. I'm convinced that no two other individuals out there could possibly match the intelligence, diligence, and experience that you brought to this substantive team. It has been an honor working with both of you over these past months. I cannot wait to see what amazing things I'm sure the two of you will go on to do. Thank you for being alongside me here at the final chapter of my high school MUN career. Next, Joyce, your Undersecretary General for General Assemblies, will start off what I'm sure you have all been waiting for, the presentation of committee awards.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Joyce Chen, and I have had the distinction of serving as your Undersecretary General of General Assemblies for VeeamON 2021. Over the course of this weekend, delegates in the General Assemblies had the opportunity to debate in a variety of committees centered firmly on some of today's most prominent issues, ranging from multifaceted topics like the role of organized crime and political suppression, to worldwide policy concerns like healthcare disparities for Indigenous peoples. This year, the VeeamON team aspired to create a program that would both enrich and inspire. I hope that you, as delegates, found your experience in committee truly rewarding. But before I call the first DAIS team up, I'd like to take a moment to appreciate the staff's extensive contributions to the success of this weekend. You took the words, "diplomacy is not a spectator sport," and brought them to life. You took our dream for the conference and brought it to fruition. And for that, we can't thank you enough. Now, finally, time for awards, which we want to remind you are by no means a measure of your experience nor skill as a delegate. Please know that you will all leave VeeamON having learned or done something new. However, with that in mind, I now call upon the dais of the Disarmament and International Security Committee.
Good afternoon, delegates, sponsor teachers, fellow staff, and secretariat. My name is Emily Nee, and I've had the distinct pleasure of serving as the Director for the Disarmament and International Security Committee at the 20th iteration of VeeamON. This past weekend, DISEC delved into nuanced, comprehensive, and fruitful discussions on global piracy and the Anglophone crisis in Cameroon. So comprehensive, in fact, that we passed our first resolution paper at 10 p.m. on Saturday. From killing 81 million people via nuclear weapons during the morning crisis, to the Nigerian bloc's affectionate zeal for the terms PogChamp and swag money during resolution paper writing, the latter term with a dollar sign in place of the S, I can confidently say that the entire dais was over the moon with how lucky we were to have such a fantastic group of passionate, intelligent, and epic delegates. Of course, I'm also incredibly grateful for my staff team. To my chair, Leo, even in the depths of sleep deprivation and resolution paper editing, your enthusiastic smile and kind-hearted guidance was constant, even if your Wi-Fi wasn't. To my ADs, Michelle, your attention to detail and work ethic was the glue that held us together. And David, your steady hand using chairmon and steadier voice while chairing was the backbone of the committee. This VeeamON marks my fifth and final iteration of a conference near and dear to my heart. I want to commend the entire secretariat team for their tireless dedication. From red to blue, thank you. In particular, I want to thank Joyce Chen, whom you know as your USG General Assemblies, but whom I know as my best friend. Thank you for giving me the privilege of entering into the final stretch of our journey side by side, even if not in a way we had originally imagined. Every year, and this year in particular, watching delegates become absorbed into resolution paper writing, form inside jokes and memories, and transform from shy speakers to persuasive negotiators, I'm reminded of the friends I've met, memories I've made, and lessons I've learned from this non-spectator sport. My only hope is that I've helped to give back a fraction of what MUN has given to me, to my delegates. Without further ado, on to awards. Best research goes to Sierra Leone, honorable mentions go to South Korea and the United States, outstanding delegates go to the Central African Republic and Liberia, and best delegate goes to Nigeria.
Please welcome the dais of the Social, Cultural, and Humanitarian Committee.
My name is Emma Jane Burns, and it has been my utmost pleasure to direct SOCHM at this iteration of VMUN. To start, I would like to thank the dais team that helped me make this weekend so successful and special. To Justin, your organization and diligence made this weekend an ease. To Anik, thank you for always being calm and ready for any situation. And to Lily, thank you for your kindness. I have thoroughly enjoyed my time working with you all. Now to the delegates of SOCHM. A huge thanks is in order for you as well. Before the conference began, I was the slightest bit worried that it would be hard to engage all delegates in such a large committee online. However, I quickly found that my fears were for naught. In SOCHM, every delegate was truly exceptional. The committee was boisterous, and each delegate had something to say. The passion and intellect I saw in SOCHM impressed me, and made me proud to have had the opportunity to direct this committee. Delegates always kept the dais on its toes, and were never afraid to ask about ROP, pose questions, and bring their opinions to light. Thank you. I would like to conclude with awards. Best research goes to Norway for their well-prepared paper and diligent work in writing draft resolutions. Honorable mentions goes to Sri Lanka and Fiji for their consistency and collaboration. Outstanding delegates goes to the U.S. for their compelling speeches and consistent passion, and to Saudi Arabia for their comprehensive and extensive work on draft resolutions. Best delegate goes to the delegate of Brazil for their constant passion for the committee. Thank you.
I'd like to invite the dais of the World Health Organization.
Dear delegates, sponsor teachers, and esteemed guests, my name is Alishba Irfan, and it has been my utmost pleasure to have served as the director of the World Health Organization at this iteration of VMUN. Over the course of this weekend, the dais and I witnessed exhilarating debate, comprehensive resolutions, and a nuanced understanding of foreign policy and global affairs. Despite the advanced structures of the pharmaceutical industry and the complex intertwined web of barriers to healthcare, the committee thoroughly succeeded in discussing the two topics at hand: the inaccessibility of medicine and childhood obesity. Perhaps the most eventful portion of the committee was the anonymous confession form that received hundreds of responses, the delegates of who told tales of drowning in the waters of Greece or flinging their sticky toy chickens to the roof of their schools in the middle of class. But the anonymous responses brought a sea of wholesomeness, including sweet confessions to other delegates, rather peculiar attempts to date the director's cat, and most importantly, heartwarming messages to the dais. On the note of the dais, I could not have ventured through this weekend without the presence of my magnificent team. Their attendance during this conference made my VMUN experience complete. To Kevin, my dazzling chair, your leadership and expertise were truly appreciated. Thank you for acting as a role model for delegates and a beacon of light for the dais as well. To my marvelous assistant directors, Brandon, you stuck by my side at the earliest and latest hours to ensure that I would not face my directorship duties alone, and provided support on every avenue. For that, I'm utterly grateful. Lauren, underneath that kind person is someone who is both confident and humorous. Thank you for holding the committee together with your impeccable note-taking, resilience, and brilliant remarks. Now, my delegates, who impress me in every speech, directive, and clause, know that your diligence and contributions will never go unnoticed. Though I wish I could recognize all of you for your spectacular achievements, I would like to highlight the following delegates. The Best Research Delegate is awarded to the United States of America. The Honorable Mention is awarded to the delegates of New Zealand and China. The Outstanding Delegate Award is given to South Africa and the United Kingdom. And the Best Delegate is awarded to the Russian Federation. Though the conference has come to an end, your learning and growth will forever persist. Thank you for the exceptional experience, and I wish you all the best in your future endeavors.
Please welcome the dais of the United Nations Human Rights Council.
Good afternoon, sponsor teachers, delegates, and fellow staff. My name is Nick Liu, and I have had the distinct privilege of serving as director of the United Nations Human Rights Council for this online iteration of VMUN. Throughout the weekend, our delegates intensely debated on the topics of human rights of migrant workers and strengthening whistleblower protection policies. Alongside myself at the staff table were two of the best DICE members that I could ask for. My chair, the rad and radiant Rafiq, was a dependable friend who could withstand the most intense debates and convoluted directives. Thank you for my assistant director, the kind and knowledgeable Katrina, who was always there with her dandy list of over 150 adjectives to compliment the delegates. Amidst the fiery debate that ensued to protect human rights, there were a few moments of levity that truly made this committee one to remember. Some highlights include doing yoga during break, Czech Republic's POG plans, dog pictures, Spain's stories about skiing into blind men, and finally, the committee's banding together to name my Christmas tree. Some of the names included Butter Nick and Butter Nick to Tree. Although I was first apprehensive of directing an online conference, this UNHRC's enthusiasm and passionate debate made it all worthwhile. Now, awards, which might I add were excruciatingly difficult to decide. Nevertheless, we would like to award Best Research to the Delegate of Qatar, Honorable Mentions to the Delegate of Australia and Germany, Outstanding Delegate to Fiji, and finally, Best Delegate to the Delegate of Saudi Arabia. Thank you.
I now call upon the dais of the United Nations Educational, Scientific, and Cultural Organization.
Good afternoon, teachers, secretariat members, fellow staff, and of course, delegates. My name is Angel Yuan, and it is my absolute pleasure to serve as a director of UNESCO at VMUN 2021. When I first started my MUN journey in grade 8, I was a shy delegate at the back of the room who would speak maybe once a committee session. I never imagined that 5 years later, I would be at the front of the virtual committee room delivering my director speech in pajama pants. Sorry, I meant full Western business attire. Although we weren't able to undergo the traditional Hotel MUN experience, we replaced dinners in downtown with DoorDash deliveries, note passing with private messages, and placards with virtual hands. Now, a few thank yous. First, thank you to the secretariat team for continuing to push the boundaries of Model United Nations, even in unprecedented times like these. From topic selections to crisis planning, thank you especially to Joyce and Derek for being so supportive during the entire substantive process. Next, thank you to my amazing DICE team, Angela Liu and Daniel Roosevelt. Angela, your invaluable contributions to debate, as well as your hard work behind the scenes, did not go unnoticed. It would have been a shame to have lost out on this weekend with you as my trusty chair. Daniel, your approachability and humor kept the committee smiling and engaged, and you impressed me with your exceptional competency. You were an absolute Roosevelt to work alongside this weekend. And lastly, thank you to my dear delegates. Although I was initially worried about directing an online committee, you made all the screen time and sitting worth it. The pride and joy I felt watching all of you speak can only be compared to the pride and joy I felt after getting my driver's license, despite running over a curb during my test. And while running over a curb may still allow you to pass, we learned that running over a dead possum will lead you to automatically fail, as evidenced by the delegate of South Korea. Despite the 3 revotes it took to pass a resolution paper and our assistant director being possessed by Disco Cat, there is no other group of people I would have rather spent my weekend with. To end off, we would like to recognize a few delegates who stood out and surpassed our expectations with awards. Best Research goes to the delegate of Uganda. Honorable Mentions go to the delegates of India and United Kingdom. Outstanding Delegate goes to the delegate of the Democratic Republic of the Congo. And the Best Delegate goes to the delegate of South Korea. Thank you, and I hope to see you all again in the near future.
Please welcome the dais of the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime.
Good afternoon. My name is Cindy Zhang, and I had the pleasure of serving as the Director of the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime at VMUN 2021. For 3 days and 2 nights, delegates of this committee discussed 2 critical topics: the role of organized crime in political suppression and the decriminalization of drugs. There were a plethora of ideas presented to the committee over the weekend, ranging from the complete legalization of specific street drugs to ensuring maximum transparency and accountability in all UN member states. Truth be told, I had little to no idea of what to expect on Friday afternoon. This was actually my first time staffing in more than a year following the cancellation of all conferences due to the pandemic, and preparation could only take me so far. However, the brilliant ideas and warm environment my delegates brought to the table quickly washed away all of my worries. From fergaliciously scrumdiddlyumptious adjectives to the United States' seemingly never-ending acronyms, I can affirm that this weekend was quite the success. However, I cannot continue without thanking my dais members, Victoria Munro and Eric Lee. Thank you for being on top of all the questions and tasks the delegates hurled at us and for being such kind-hearted individuals. To Victoria, thank you for being an amazingly calming presence amidst the chaos you witnessed during committee sessions, and as Eric and I bickered for hours on end. To Eric, I think I can speak on behalf of the committee when I say that you talk quite eloquently. Your very presence and ability to smoothly catch mistakes are simply unparalleled. 1,000 points to the both of you. Before we continue on to awards, I would like to emphasize that I had a challenging time deciding them. I'm sure that all of you have heard this countless times, but I genuinely mean this from the bottom of my heart. If I could, I would give each and every one of you an award for the enthusiasm and innovative ideas you brought to the conference. Even if you leave VMUN 2021 physically empty-handed, I hope you leave with memories of an unforgettable weekend. Now, the part all of you have been waiting for, awards. Best research goes to the delegation of Philippines. Honorable mention goes to the delegation of Afghanistan and Ghana. Outstanding delegate goes to the delegation of China. And best delegate goes to the delegation of the United States of America. Congratulations to everyone, and I look forward to meeting you again at VMUN 2022.
I now call upon the dais of the United Nations Environment Program.
Good afternoon, all. My name is Nikki Wu, and I had the distinct honor of serving as the director of the United Nations Environment Program. Alongside my lovely chair and AD Lincoln Lee and Yuri Tao, we have to admit that we had quite the tumultuous weekend for what is known as a peaceful environmental committee. From swaying Russian corporate paramilitaries to discussing the nuance of preserving biodiversity, we engaged in quite the intense debate for the past 2 days. This committee has surpassed my expectations with their research, with an unexplainable affinity for animal protection and the prevention of poaching. It is safe to say that every single delegate made the 7 a.m. wake up and staring at my computer screen worth it. While every member of this committee did their share in contributing to debate and really stood out and merit recognition in my book, I'm obliged to pick a couple of delegates that really stood out in debate. That being said, awards are as follows. Best research goes to Germany, honorable mention goes to Turkey, and another honorable mention goes to Colombia. Outstanding delegate goes to Canada, and best delegate goes to China. Thank you all for the really exciting weekend.
Please welcome the dais of the United Nations Development Program.
Good afternoon. My name is Madeline Kim, and I have had the privilege of serving as a director of the UNDP this past weekend at VMUN 2021. It has now officially been 1 year since I attended the most recent Hotel Model UN conference held in person in the Greater Vancouver area. I'm not gonna lie, I miss it a lot. I miss knocking on the table until my knuckles turn blue. I miss making instant noodles at 3 a.m. because we can't decide where to go for dinner. And get this, I even miss the smell of Axe body spray and body odor at the delegate social. Despite the unusual circumstances under which this conference has taken place, I can proudly say that I could have never asked for a better directing experience at VMUN 2021. Noah, my chair, thank you for being the most tech-savvy member on this team, although it really isn't a high bar, to be honest. Your consistency and tirelessness made you the rock of this team. Jan, my AD, thank you for covering all the blind spots I'm sure would have been otherwise overlooked. Your comical green smarty obsession and ability to put a smile on our faces made you the glue of this team. Most importantly, thank you to the delegates of the UNDP for your unbridled passion and spirit. From Burundi finding every opportunity to hound Iran, to the delegate of India forgetting to turn off his camera and accidentally giving us a tour of his home on break, you certainly made my weekend anything other than boring. While I believe you have all jumped leaps and bounds in your abilities as delegates this weekend, the dais would like to acknowledge a few select individuals. Now, the time you have all been waiting for, awards. The award for Best Research Delegate goes to Turkey. The honorable mention goes to France and Kenya. The award for Outstanding Delegate goes to Iran. And last but not least, the award for Best Delegate goes to Germany. Congratulations.
I'd like to invite the dais of the United Nations World Tourism Organization.
Good afternoon, delegates, sponsor teachers, secretariat, staff, and distinguished guests. My name is Jasper, and over the past 3 days, it has been my pleasure to direct the United Nations World Tourism Organization at VIMUN 2021. When I first entered the Zoom meeting, anxiously planning the first committee session with my fellow dais members, I was unsure how the delegates would debate and take at hand the two pressing issues of tourism's environmental impacts and the increasing weaknesses of economies reliant on tourism, as well as a joint crisis involving an outbreak of HIV. I owe it to both my colleagues on the dais and my delegates for making this committee such an astounding success. Owen and Emily, thank you for being there when I needed you, for being flexible, for engaging the committee, and for dealing with all of our issues. I could not have pulled this off without you, and much of this committee's success is the result of your hard work and dedication. I could not ask for more talented and compassionate dais members. To the delegates, thank you for making my vision of the UNWTO come to life, for embracing the debate so enthusiastically, and for working together through adversity. You exhibited the epitome of what it means to be a Model UN delegate, and I'm proud of every one of you. Even with an online conference, you managed to beat the odds and create something reminiscent of the hotel conferences we all yearned for. Finally, the part many of you are nervously waiting for, awards. As is often the case, I would award each and every one of you for your persistence and dedication, but nonetheless, a few delegates stood out exceptionally. For a demonstration of exceptional knowledge, research, and reasoning skills, Best Research Delegate goes to the delegation of Italy. For making invaluable contributions to the committee, both in debate and unmoderated caucuses, honorable mentions go to the delegations of Maldives and Spain. For exceptional speaking, collaboration, and diplomacy, outstanding delegate goes to the delegation of Russia. And finally, for leading the committee through triumph and peril, and making extraordinary contributions during debate, discussions, and outside the committee room, best delegate goes to the delegation of China. Congratulations, award winners and delegates on a successful weekend. Everyone should be extremely proud of what they have accomplished. Thank you.
Next, Ethan, your Undersecretary General for Specialized Agencies, will continue with the presentation of committee awards for our regional bodies and crisis committees.
Good afternoon. My name is Ethan Jasny, and I had the honor of serving as Undersecretary General of Specialized Agencies for VIMUN 2021. This year, our specialized agencies took us all the way back to the exhilarating battles of the Crimean War, to the contemporary issues of police and prison reform that nations around the world are grappling with, and to a future conflict between the United States and the narco states of Central and South America. In short, our incredible dais teams worked around the clock to create complex topics and crises that literally defied the clock. I want to thank all of our staff who remained committed to writing excellent backgrounders and crisis plans despite this year's conference's altered format. As a reminder, winning or not winning an award should not define your Model UN experience. Just the act of showing up and speaking up, especially in these troubling times, is laudable in demonstrating your commitment to global diplomacy, peace, and progress. With that in mind, please welcome the dais of the North Atlantic Treaty Organization.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is David, and I've had the distinct privilege of serving as the director of the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, or NATO for short. Over the past few days, our committee debated two topics, Russian expansionism and arms control and non-proliferation. During these topics, I was constantly amazed by delegates' composure and eagerness to debate during our committee sessions. All delegates contributed something unique to the committee and were extremely adaptable to every circumstance that was thrown at them. From the fruitful discussions about reducing reliance on Russian resources to the exciting debate of NATO's nuclear sharing program, delegates in NATO were able to carefully navigate the world of diplomacy while also taking initiative to further their own learning. Although things were mostly productive, memories such as the 11-clause, 9-page resolution paper and the not-so-productive, unmoderated caucuses are memories that I will never forget. On behalf of the dais team, thank you delegates for making VIMUN 2021 an amazing experience, despite it being online. I also want to give a special thank you to my chair, Naomi, and my assistant director, Leah. NATO would not have been possible without your dedication and professionalism. Delegates, at the beginning of the conference, I ask you to be mindful that these next few days are going to be a learning experience. I ask you to not be afraid of making mistakes and to challenge yourself and others. I can confidently say, after 5 committee sessions, that you all have learned and grown as debaters, negotiators, and most importantly, leaders. I hope your experience in NATO is just the first step of many that you will undertake to become the leaders of our next generation. With all this being said, I will now be moving on to awards. Please remember that awards are not a measure of your success as a delegate over the past 3 days, and that regardless of the outcome of the awards, you should all be proud of your growth. Nevertheless, best position paper goes to Germany, honorable mentions go to Croatia and the US, outstanding delegate goes to Albania, and best delegate goes to Poland. Thank you, delegates.
I now call upon the dais of the European Union.
Good afternoon, delegates, distinguished guests, and teacher chaperones. My name is Austin Ma, and I've had the distinct honor of serving as the Director of the European Union at VIMA in 2021. Over the past weekend, delegates of the EU thoroughly explored and discussed the alarming topics of EU and Turkey, as well as immigrant integration. Despite the inherent complexities of the topics at hand, delegates of the EU successfully passed 2 resolutions to address both pertinent issues. From the infamous moments of anticipation before the qualified majority vote results were revealed to the ever so rambunctious Zoom general chat, there was never a dull moment in the EU. However, the one aspect of the committee that stood out to me was the special camaraderie and unbridled passion displayed by the EU delegates. Watching the careful negotiations and discussion take place within the virtual committee room was certainly quite the spectacle to watch. I hope that the VIMA experience this weekend has helped you develop or perhaps spark a passion within you for the art of diplomacy, and I hope to see you continue to make your way around the Munn circuit and discover the limitless possibilities and opportunities that await you in the roads ahead. To my dais members, Jasmine and Finn, thank you so much for fulfilling your roles above and beyond of what was asked of you. The committee would not have ran as smoothly as it did without all your help. Your abilities to connect with and encourage delegates are simply unparalleled, and I'm so grateful to have you guys on the team, and I couldn't have asked for a better chair and assistant director than yourselves. I also want to give a big heartfelt thank you to the VIMA 2021 Secretariat, the ones who have spent the last 8 to 10 months organizing this conference. In particular, Derek, I'm infinitely grateful for everything you have done for me as well as the European Union. Your advice was paramount to the success of this committee this weekend. I also want to profusely thank Ethan for his help and edits pertaining to the background or writing process. Now onto the awards. Before they are presented, I want to truly note that the award selection process was nothing short of difficult. Every delegate in the EU provided unique analysis and strong points to the discussion. The engagement in the committee, in short, was just overwhelming. All in all, please do not allow awards to disincentivize your future participation in Munn. Munn is so much bigger than awards, so I implore you to look past it and simply just focusing on perfecting your craft as a diplomat. With that being said, the awards are as follows. Best Research Delegate is awarded to France for his well-informed speeches and contributions to his respective blocs. Honorable mentions are awarded to Spain and Germany for their invaluable contributions to every discussion topic at hand. Outstanding Delegate is awarded to Poland for his unwavering leadership and consistency throughout the conference. And finally, Best Delegate is awarded to Italy for her charisma, leadership, selflessness, and captivating speeches, emulating the qualities of a true EU diplomat. Thank you.
I'd like to invite the dais of the International Democrat Union.
My name is Kai Choi, and I have had the honor and privilege of serving as the director for the International Democrat Union. It is difficult to believe that since Friday, 15 entire hours of debate have occurred, and I have not walked up or down a single flight of hotel stairs or shaken a single hand. And I was apprehensive about the virtual format because, to me, Model UN has always hinged on a sense of space, of large rooms and busy clusters of delegates. But 15 hours later, I've realized that this is not why I've returned again and again. I've returned because of the people. So I'd like to thank my delegates who presented themselves as an exceptionally fast-paced, passionate, and fast-learning group of individuals, who gracefully dove into the nuances of conservative climate action and conservative voter appeal, who, during the morning crisis, participated in a game of conservative Among Us. I'll leave the details of that up to you. And I'd like to also thank my staff, my chair Sophia Chong and my assistant director James Zhang, whose consistent efforts and efficiency were crucial to the success of the committee. These are the people that have transported me from the isolation of my room into VeeamON 2021. Not a space, but an experience I'll cherish. Once again, this was a competitive, interdependent group of individuals. Removing any single delegate would have dampened the committee's frenetic energy, but there are four delegates in particular whose efforts I would like to commend. For this delegate's exceptionally insightful paper that was a pleasure to read, the Best Research Delegate Award goes to the United Kingdom Conservative and Unionist Party. For this delegate's continual defense of their controversial stances and their infinite determination to fight impossible battles, the honorable mention goes to the German Christian Democratic Union. For this delegate's ability to weave conservative ideology and party slogans into poetic, forward-thinking, and unifying statements, the Outstanding Delegate Award goes to the Indian Bharata Janata Party. And for this delegate's visceral diatribes, consistently polarizing opinions, and adjectives so game-changing that the dais had to stop the game, the Best Delegate Award goes to the Australian Liberal Party. Thank you.
I now call upon the dais of the House of Commons.
Good afternoon, delegates, sponsor teachers, secretariat, and fellow staff members. My name is Cynthia Gann, and I've had the honor of serving as your speaker for the House of Commons at VeeamON 2021. 2 years ago, I walked into this committee as a terrified first-time delegate, and it is truly an honor to end off my very last VeeamON here as well. This weekend, the House tackled the topic of police and RCMP reform, successfully passing a bill addressing the areas of police funding, regulation and accountability, and racial inequity. While delegates attempted to incorporate compromise into the world of partisan politics, there was never a dull moment in the House, whether it was the Prime Minister impressively managing to evade every single question during question period, or a vivid story of being beat up by Chandler from Friends. From the moment I was corrected on a point of order 30 seconds into our first committee session, to highly unsynced but equally passionate cries of shocked and appalled, I am proud to say that the virtual format did not change this year's quality of debate in the slightest, with the exception of a few additional landmarks, namely the banana, IKEA moon on the deputy opposition leader's wall. I speak on behalf of the entire dais when I say that we could not have asked for a more ambitious, interesting, or enthusiastic group of MPs. Of course, none of this would have been possible without my incredible team. To my deputy speaker, Matthew, from one side of the dais table to the other, it's been a long ride for both of us in this committee. Thank you for making this last one the most memorable yet. To Ellie, Ryan, and Caitlin, your quick thinking, attentiveness, and genuine care for the members truly made this weekend shine. I still don't know how I got so lucky to have you all, but thank you. And to our MPs, we truly felt there were so many exceptional members and not enough awards. However, I hope that you have all gained something this weekend, whether knowledge, confidence, or simply a fond memory, worth more than any award. To say I am incredibly proud of each and every single one of you would be an understatement. With that being said, awards are as follows. The award for Best Research Delegate goes to the leader of the official opposition in the House of Commons. The honorable mentions go to the Minister of Justice and the Prime Minister. The award for Outstanding Delegate goes to the leader of the Bloc Québécois. And the leader for Best Delegate goes to the Minister for Crown Indigenous Relations. Thank you.
I now call upon the dais of the U.S. House of Representatives.
Delegates, staff, chaperones, and secretariat, my name is Betty Pan, and I've had the honor of serving as the director and presiding officer for the United States House of Representatives. Let me begin by saying that the U.S. House of Representatives and team and committee can only be described as cash money. To my wonderful committee chair, Ellen Lee, and assistant director, Byung-jun Moon, I want to sincerely thank you for all the time and effort you put into making our committee a success. Ellen and BJ, though I did occasionally take away your screen sharing privileges, and for good reason, I cannot thank you enough for your diligence and patience. To my amazing co-director, Josh Dar Santos, thank you for all the late night citation sessions and for always being ready to lend a helping hand. You were always so organized and knowledgeable, and I knew I could always count on you. And now, my delegates. To my bagel lovers, premium air enthusiasts, and Fergalicious friends, I can honestly say I have never been more impressed by a group of delegates. Every one of your speeches and contributions showed me that you all came prepared and ready for the conference, and for that, I thank you for your dedication and hard work. Now, the moment you've all been waiting for. Awards. Please remember that not receiving an award is in no way an indication of your Model UN ability. In my 4 years at Model UN, I've actually never won an award. You can take away what you want from that fact, but to me, I know that awards never deterred me from continuing my Model UN journey, and I urge you to do the same. So, sappy story aside, here are the awards. Best Research goes to Representative Cedric L. Richmond from the 2nd District of Louisiana. Honorable Mentions go to Representative Carolyn Maloney from the 12th District of New York and Nancy Pelosi, Speaker of the House of Representatives. Outstanding Delegate goes to Representative Ilhan Omar from the 5th District of Minnesota. And finally, Best Delegate goes to Representative Matt Gaetz from the 1st District of Florida. Thank you again.
I now call upon the dais of the U.S. Senate.
Good afternoon, sponsor teachers, secretariat, staff members, and delegates. My name is Joshua DarSantos, and it was my distinct pleasure to serve as the Vice President of the United States, Michael R. Pence, the President of the 116th United States Senate. Starting on the military-industrial complex, senators had to debate through thick and thin for the betterment of the future of the United States, discussing topics such as the revolving door and the effects of campaign funding from defense companies. Moving on to the topic of prison reform, senators had to debate topics such as solitary confinement and the understaffing and overcrowding of U.S. prisons. After being told that I had the task of running the first ever U.S. Congress committee in the long and vast history of VMUN, I surely had a lot on my plate. From Senator Rubio's statements that nothing is more American than a Chevy, apple pie, and the United States military, to Derek's flawless impersonation of President Donald J. Trump, I sincerely hope that this online VMUN experience was nothing short of memorable for all senators, and I thank all of you for making this committee such a joy to run. However, none of this would be possible without the amazing team that I have around me. Kathy, your pristine chairing abilities paved the way for how smoothly this committee ran over the weekend. And Mike, your extensive knowledge of congressional procedure allowed for bills to be edited and passed with grace and efficiency. Last, but definitely not least, Betty, we had a huge task planning this committee, and working with you for the past 6 months has made my first directing experience nothing short of unforgettable. And with that, to all of those in the U.S. Congress staff team, I thank each and every one of you for your unwavering commitment and dedication to this new committee. Now onto the part that everyone has been waiting for, awards. I know that this sounds cliche, but I genuinely wish that I could have given every single one of you an award. But the show must go on. That being said, best research goes to Senator Chuck Schumer. Honorable mention goes to Senators Dick Durbin and Marco Rubio. Outstanding delegate goes to Senator Bernie Sanders. And finally, best delegate goes to Senator Michael Bennett. Once again, thank you, Senators, the U.S. Congress staff team, and the Secretariat of VMUN for making this iteration of VMUN one for the record books.
Please welcome the dais of the United Nations Security Council.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Andrew Liu, and over the past 3 days, I have had the privilege of serving as Director of the United Nations Security Council at this year's iteration of Vancouver Model United Nations. This year's Security Council plunged into the internal issue of misconduct among United Nations peacekeepers, which threatened the legitimacy of the Council itself, as well as the delicate political and social situation in war-torn South Sudan. Over these 3 days of debate, we saw the Security Council band together and achieve compromise, managing to unanimously adopt a comprehensive resolution paper for our first topic on peacekeeping malpractice. And for our second topic on South Sudan, delegates went above and beyond in their efforts to cooperate with each other, including as many fellow delegates as they could in discussions and desperately trying their very best to stop P5 countries from vetoing everything. We finished things off with a fast-paced and exciting joint morning crisis with NATO, and I'm thoroughly impressed that all delegates spoke passionately, contributing to solving the issues thrown at them and fulfilled their role within the Security Council, truly capturing the spirit of diplomacy. To Stephanie, my chair, who worked tirelessly alongside me on the dais team, Thank you so much for being the most dependable and reliable chair I could ever have asked for. It is due to your dedication that this committee was able to run so smoothly in this new virtual environment. Without your willingness to help, your amazing skills with chairman, and your versatility, this committee would definitely not be the same. Everyone in the Security Council brought an enthusiasm and an excitement that any DAIS team would be lucky to have. That being said, even among this pool of exceptional diplomats, there are a few delegates we would like to recognize. Each decision was truly difficult to make, and we commend you for your participation this weekend. The awards are as follows. Best Research Delegate is awarded to the Delegate of Kenya. The Honorable Mention is awarded to the Delegate of Vietnam. Outstanding Delegate is awarded to the Delegate of the United Kingdom. And finally, Best Delegate is awarded to the Delegate of Norway. Congratulations to you all.
I now call upon the dais of the Joint Crisis Committees.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ben Kang, and it has been my distinct honor to serve as the director of the Joint Crisis Committees at this iteration of VMUN. To begin, I'd like to acknowledge and thank my full JCC team, for they were the true driving force behind the committees' success. Thank you to my block directors, Adam and Richard, chairs Harvey and Peter, and crisis staff Hannah and Chris. Thank you for all that you have done for the committees. Without your tireless dedication and passion, the JCC truly would have been nothing at all. And to you, JCC delegates, ever since that first uncertain moment that debate kicked off in new and uncharted online territory for many of us, ever since that first moment, my fellow DAIS team and I have been constantly impressed by your dedication to your bloc and commitment to the success of your nation. Even working through the most stubborn of technical difficulties, of which there were many, your ingenuity, creativity, and resourcefulness in debating the crisis honestly shone through, and it was truly invigorating for the team and I to witness it. Whether it was the cholera outbreaks within the army camps of both blocs, or the double agents among the committees, no matter what we threw at you, no matter what you were confronted by, your unwavering ability to devise the most insightful strategies and most efficient solutions and most effective and considerate responses made our jobs as your crisis staff so much easier and, more importantly, so much more enjoyable. Even as I scrolled through the JCC directives portal after the end of committee session 5, I still had trouble reconciling the fact that you, between the two blocks, cumulatively submitted over 600 unique decrees, edicts, ordinances, communiques, press releases, and memoranda, which resulted in over 200 unique crisis-affecting events. These numbers stand testament to you, the delegates of the JCC, and to your unwavering dedication to the crisis. Thank you for it all. It has truly been a joy to direct the committee. And so, lastly, what everyone has been waiting for, the awards. I'd like to remind all delegates that by no means are awards a measure of your individual success, and we'd simply like to just recognize a few delegates for the contributions. For the JCC Coalition Bloc, honorable mention goes to the British Master General of the Ordnance, Fitzroy Somerset, 1st Baron Raglan. Outstanding delegate goes to British politician Henry John Temple, 3rd Viscount Palmerston. And best delegate goes to the Ottoman Grand Vizier, Mustafa Rezid Pasha. For the JCC Russia Bloc, honorable mention goes to the Vice Admiral Pavel Nakhimov. Outstanding delegate goes to the Minister of Internal Affairs, Lev Perovsky. And best delegate goes to the Minister of the Navy, Alexander Sergeyevich Menshikov. Congratulations to you all, and we hope you had a great time in the JCC.
I'd like to invite the dais of the Historical Crisis Committee.
Good afternoon. My name is Anushka, and I have had the honor of directing the Historical Crisis Committee alongside my excellent chair, Alec Yang, and assistant director, Logan Higgins. This year, delegates represented members of the Congolese government during the Congo Crisis of 1960, a Cold War-era conflict which emerged after the Congo was granted independence by Belgium. Over the course of the weekend, delegates tackled a range of crises, including a war crimes trial featuring Commander Commander and a riveting hostage crisis. At the same time, the committee navigated the very real struggles of the decolonization process and were able to rise to the challenge of unpacking complicated issues, whether it was ethnic violence or the role of natural resources in a developing economy. As a dais, we were thoroughly impressed with the efforts of all delegates and were particularly proud of our delegates for consistently staying engaged despite the unusual online format of the conference. With that in mind, we'll be recognizing the following delegates for their exceptionally diplomatic and thoughtful participation in this committee. Firstly, for his well-written and intelligent paper on the importance of education in the Congo, the award for best research goes to the Premier Burgomaster of Leopoldville. The honorable mention for this committee goes to a delegate with clever directives and a collaborative approach to solving crises, that is General Victor Landula. Next, because of his energetic and rhetorically compelling speeches, the award for outstanding delegate goes to the Prime Minister of the Republic of the Congo. And finally, the award for best delegate goes to a delegate who invariably stuck to the stance of his position and whose remarks were always concise yet powerful. Congratulations to the leader of the CONACAT. Thank you to all delegates for making this committee a fun and worthwhile experience, and I hope to see you all next year.
I'd like to invite the dais of the Fictional Crisis Committee.
As a wise sailor from El Salvador once said, it's not the size of the wave, but the motion of the ocean. If there's anything that can be taken away from the narco state of 2035, it is to accept where the tides of life take you. Good afternoon. My name is Jeremy Fang, and I had the pleasure of directing the Fictional Crisis Committee. Whether it be references to Casino Royale or visits from our favorite Peruvian freedom fighter, Delta, the FCC delegates tackled every crisis with unparalleled enthusiasm and creativity. Despite the occasional directive form difficulties or confusing economic policy, the delegates persevered. The dais team was extremely impressed by each and every one of your contributions and efforts this weekend. To my amazing dais team, Kobe and Sakura, you two were the heart and soul of this committee. Kobe, your endless stream of positivity not only yielded an army of stands, but kept everything lighthearted when things weren't going exactly to plan. We all hope your jaw and head are all right. Sakura, thank you for your quick thinking and willingness to help. Whether it be with directives, committee direction, or accidentally leaking future crisis updates, without you, this committee would not have been the same. I honestly could not have asked for a better dais team. Our functional dysfunctionality was truly unique. I'd like to give a quick shout out to Daniel Amenbach for helping us spread the workload for a few sessions. Your efforts were very much appreciated. Thank you all for making my final year of Model UN that much more special. Before I move on to awards, I would like to reiterate that awards are by no means a measure of your success this weekend. The lessons and memories that you will take away from this weekend are infinitely more valuable. With that in mind, honorable mention goes to the Colombian Minister of Culture and Propaganda. Outstanding delegate goes to the Mexican Secretary of Labor and Social Welfare. And best delegate goes to the Mexican Attorney General. Thank you.
Please welcome the dais of the Advanced Crisis Committee.
Bona tarda. I'm this Michael Borges, y es un placer ser el director del Comité de Crisis Avanzada para Cuesta y Terrasco de Lima 2021. Now, I just spoke a bit of Catalan, and I suppose it's just a way to impress anyone watching this live stream. But regardless of what I do or say in this speech, nothing will ever compare to the greatness of my ACC committee. I'm not a fan of hyperbole, but I am a fan of the ACC. And the fact of the matter is, the ACC is one of the hardest, if not the hardest committee in VIMA 2021. These are just some of the few things we had to go through as a committee. We had an election, investigated tax evasion, had to find some missing fancy cars, and witnessed the prowess of the Secretary General as a soap opera star. I had to act as a SoundCloud rapper, and I heard from the delegates some really cool zingers. stuck in a porta potty was Lionel Messi. And somehow, we also had to deal with sci-fi movies. We had impeachment in our hands while we savored a secret political romance. It only showed how the council was just a bunch of degenerates, but that's what made them the greatest delegates. Despite the hurdles I threw at them, it was an honor to be part of that committee. Because the fact of the matter is, they gave me the charisma, uniqueness, nerve, and talent needed to thrive in this committee. I'd like to thank my dais team for 1 second, Ethan and Joyce. They were the ones who balanced each other out during the committee. While I was being neurotic and losing my mind because of the directives, they were calm, cool, collected at the midst of all of the agony. So I thank them truly. I'd also like to thank my delegates. But before I gush about them, I just want to say a couple of things. Being their director, has been agonizing, to say the least. I was becoming neurotic, losing my mind by the fact that they were planning things I never expected they planned. But regardless of the hassle I had to go through, I would never change a thing about my committee. My delegates are passionate, creative. Anything you can say about people, you can say about my delegates and my dais team as well. It has been an honor being their director, and I look forward to seeing them thrive in the future endeavors in MUN and other opportunities they may have. And all I can say this to both my dais team and my delegates is thank you. I'm honored to be your director, and thank you very much. This will be my last time in my crisis committee, and I thank you so much for giving me the best experience I've ever had. Now, we'll be moving on to awards. The best research goes to the President of the Parliament. The honorable mention goes to the Secretary General of the ERC. The outstanding delegate goes to the President of the Generalitat. And the best delegate goes to the spokesperson of the government, the counselor of the presidency. Thank you so much. I look forward to seeing you thrive and have a wonderful day.
Finally, I would like to welcome our Secretary General, William Tsai, to close off the conference.
Good morning, delegates, staff, sponsor teachers, and distinguished guests. As introduced, my name is William Tsai, and this year I had the honor of serving as your Secretary General for the 20th iteration of Vancouver Model United Nations, VMUN 2021. Well, the last 3 days, and by extension the last year, have been the capstone of my 6-year-long high school Model UN experience. And while the pandemic has made it so instead of seeing your sleep-deprived faces from atop a podium, your faceless presence is only recognized by a viewer count. And while there were many times that I wish I could be standing in front of you all at the Hyatt Regency, in some way, I wouldn't change a single thing about VMUN 2021. Any way you put it, as hard as we, the Secretariat, tried to replicate past ordinary iterations, this 20th iteration of VMUN was extraordinary. And extraordinary is the exact word I would use to describe Model UN. Nowhere else will you find high school students giving up their weekend to debate foreign policy. And the fact that you will amidst a global pandemic, that's extraordinary. So if you walk away from this experience with an ordinary MUN experience like the ones you've had in past years, or an extraordinary MUN experience like one you'll never forget, I, alongside my Secretariat, will have succeeded. And when you reminisce about the past 48 hours, be it tomorrow or a year from now, please don't remember my name. Please don't remember the faces of your Secretariat, the clauses and subclauses of your resolution papers, or the awards announced here today. Instead, direct your mental library to recording the kindness of your dais team, the friends you made in the committee room, and the initiative in making every speech that you made. In a sense, that is the essence of VMUN. And so there's nothing more to say than to say a few much-needed and sincerely heartfelt thank yous. Of course, we must start with you, the delegates, who form the very basis for which we exist. Thank all 650 of you who worked tirelessly to make this conference a success. At times working against each other, but at more times working with each other. Together, in the committee room, you crafted memories that I hope you will cherish. Thank you, staff. Derek summed it up quite well, and so I have nothing more to say than a thank you for your effort. And to the sponsor teachers, thank you for all the time that you spend making sure your delegates have a successful and safe experience. I know this may not be what you expected when you first took over your school's Model UN clubs, but you've all done a phenomenal job chaperoning this weekend. This conference would not succeed to the scale that it does without you. Now for the Secretariat. Thank you, Vivian Gu, for your dedication, your endlessly positive attitude, and especially for your contributions to all aspects of the conference. I don't know if I could have survived the last 2 years of conference planning without your lighthearted nature. Thank you, Derek, for being the best chief anyone could have asked for. From sometimes being US Chief of IT or Design, editing countless backgrounders, and managing the staff of 20 committees, you truly went above and beyond your position's expectations, and I truly cannot thank you enough for your hard work, commitment, and friendship. VMUN would not be the same without you. Thank you, Tyler, for your organization of the platform, constant advice, concerns, and credence, and the countless ways you made VMUN better, shared to me on our walks to and from school each day. Like Diogenes the Cynic, your skepticism has been vital for keeping the conference on track, and VMUN is lucky to have such a passionate director of logistics. To Joyce and Ethan, thank you for taking on all aspects of your position so gracefully. From interviews to staff training and backgrounder editing, both of your work is truly appreciated, and I wouldn't have chosen anyone else. Joyce, your rom-com taste is impeccable, and to Ethan, I'm glad to know a person like you in my life who want a paperweight for Christmas. Thank you, Vivian Liang, for emailing every company I didn't want to contact, planning VMUN's first ever virtual social, and processing any little thing that needed to be bought. Sorry for stealing the first three letters of your name, Ian, and giving it to Viv. Thank you, Jonah. Your algorithmic thinking hasn't yet convinced me that you're not a robot, but at least it's kept our finances in check. I'm still not sure whether or not you can name half of our secretariat members, but your work and help is always appreciated. Thank you, Laura, for your enthusiasm, your ungodly commutes, and your persuasive saleswoman prowess. Your position of USG communications, although new to VMUN this year, was vital to the conference, especially amidst this confusing pandemic. And thank you to both of our members of our delegate affairs team, Armand and Mia, for your outstanding work throughout the conference. Having been in your shoes not too long ago, I know that your jobs are truly the hardest among us. Your real reward comes later. And lastly, thank you, Ms. Kelly. While this may have been the most unfortunate of years to take over the job of monitoring VMUN after 19 years of Mr. Griffin, you've done a wonderful job, and I wouldn't have asked for anyone else. That brings us to our next generation of secretariat members. If I may be overly boastful, but only for a second, no conference can continue without the careful guidance of its Secretary General. And I am nothing less than delighted to present to you the Secretary General of Vancouver Modern United Nations 2022, your USG of Delegate Affairs, Armand Jaffer. Also joining him next year is your new Director General, without which no SG would be complete, Mia Cao. Talented as they are, they will not be able to do this alone, and I'm sure that all of you will want to return for more. Good news, you can help make the next iteration of VMUN even better. And I'm excited to announce that secretary applications for our 21st iteration are now open at vmun.com/apply. Additionally, feedback forms for teachers and delegates will be available shortly on our website and by email. And we would really appreciate the feedback to improve this upcoming iteration. It is now my responsibility as Secretary General to formally close Vancouver Modern United Nations 2021. Thank you.